Good morning, students. In the previous video, we discussed the summary of this chapter in the Kingdom of Foods. Today, we will take line by line explanation of this chapter. In the Kingdom of Foods, as I told you, that there is a king, and his ministers were also idiots. In the Kingdom of Fools, both the king and ministers were idiots. They didn't want to run things like other kings, so they decided to change night into day and day into night. They were so foolish that they changed day into night and night into day. It means they do work at night and slept during daytime. They ordered that everyone should be awake at night till their fields and run their business only after dark. They will start their work when there is darkness and go to bed as soon as the sun came up. As soon as the sun rises, they have to sleep. Anyone who discovered would be punished with death. Who disobeyed would be punished with death. The people did as they were told for fear of death. Now, if they will not do like that, they will be punished. So, all people obey him because of the fear of death. The king and the minister were delighted, happy at the success of their project. One day, a guru and his disciple arrived in the city. Disciple, follower. Arrived in the city, it was a beautiful city. It was broad daylight, but there was no one about. Everyone was asleep, not a mouse stirring, moved. Even the cattle had been taught to sleep by day. The two strangers were amazed by what they saw around them and wandered around town till evening, when suddenly the whole town woke up and went about its nightly business. One day, a guru and his disciple reached there. They saw that it was a beautiful city. It was daylight, but there was no one on the road. Not a single creature was there. Both guru and his disciple were amazed. Amazed means surprised. When they saw there was no one till evening. During evening time, they saw that the whole town woke up and started doing their work. The two men were hungry. The two men, who are the two men? Guruji and his disciple were hungry. Now that the shops were open, they went to buy some groceries. Groceries, you know, things of daily use. To their astonishment, surprise, they found that every cost the same, a single doodoo. Whether they bought a measure of rice or a bunch of banana, the cost is same, a doodoo. The guru and his disciple were delighted. They had never heard of anything like this. They could buy all the food they wanted for a rupee. Now both guru and his disciple was hungry. They went to the market. They bought some grocery item. They were very surprised to see that the cost of everything was the same, a single rupee. Whether they could buy a measure of rice or bunch of bananas. And now both were very happy. They never heard. This is the first time when they saw in their life like this, and they could buy anything. They could buy a lot of things in a rupee. When they had cooked and eaten, the guru realized that this was a kingdom of fools, and it wouldn't be a good idea for them to stay there. Now, when they cooked at that time, and after eating, they realized that it was the kingdom of fools, it seemed. It wouldn't be a good idea for them to stay here, so they should not stay there. This is no place for us, let's go, he said to his disciple. Guru said to his disciple that they should move from there, but the disciple did not want to leave the place. Everything was cheap here. All he wanted was good, cheap food. But the disciple did not want to leave that place because he found everything was cheap there. The Guru said, they are all fools. This wouldn't last very long, and you can't tell what they will do to you next. Now Guruji said that this wouldn't last very long. If you would live here, it cannot be said what will happen next. But the disciple couldn't listen to the Guru's wisdom. He wanted to stay. The Guru finally gave up and said, do what you want, I am going, and left. The disciple stayed on, ate his fill every day, bananas and ghee, rice, wheat and fruit, and like a street side sacred bull. Now he stayed there. The disciple didn't listen his guru, and he stayed there, and daily he ate bananas, ghee, rice, wheat, and he became very fatty. One bright day, a thief broke into a rich merchant's house. He had made a hole in the wall and sneaked in. And as he was carrying out his loot, the wall of the old house collapsed on his head and killed him on the spot. It was a bright day, a thief broke into a rich merchant's house through a hole and sneaked in, entered secretly. Then he was carrying his wealth, stolen goods. At that time, the wall of the old house collapsed, fell down on his head and killed him on the spot. And the rich merchant died. His brother ran to the king and complained, your highness, when my brother was pursuing his ancient trade, a wall fell on him and killed him. This merchant is to blame. He should have built a good strong wall. You must punish the wrongdoer and compensate the family for this injustice. Pursuing, here it means doing, ancient, very old. Compensate, to give something to balance someone. Now, his brother went to the king and complained, the wall of the house collapsed on his head, on the thief's head, and killed, and he was killed there. The thief was killed. His brother ran to the king and complained, your highness, when my brother was pursuing his ancient trade, what was ancient trade? Theft. A wall fell on him and he was killed. This merchant is to blame. So, is merchant ko kya kiya jana chahiye? There should be the blame of this merchant. He should have built, to underline, good strong wall. Because of the wall, my brother was died. You must punish the wrongdoer and compensate the family. The king said, justice will be done, don't worry, and at once summoned the owner of the house. Summoned means called, the owner of the house. Now the king called the owner of the house. Who was the owner of the house? Merchant. When the merchant arrived, the king questioned him, what is your name? Such and such, your highness. He told his name. Were you at home when the dead man theft your house? Yes, my lord. He broke in and the wall was weak. It fell on him. He told him, that the ball was weak and it fell on him. The accused pleads guilty. Accused माने culprit. Pleads means requested. Your ball killed this man's brother. You have murdered him and we have to punish you. Now, the king said that because of your ball, his brother was died. So, it would be counted as a murder. So, you have to punish for that. Lord, said the helpless merchant. I didn't put up the ball. It is really the fault of the man who built the ball. He didn't build it right. You should punish him. Now the merchant was very helpless and he said that it is not his fault. It is the fault of the man who built the ball. So you should punish him. Who is that? My lord, this ball was built in my father's time. I know the man. He is an old man now. He lives nearby. Now the king asked, who is that person? The merchant told him that I know that person and that man is very old, but he lives nearby. The king sent out messengers to bring in the bricklayer who had built the wall. They brought him tied hand and foot. Now the king sent out for the bricklayer who built the wall and finally they brought him with tied hand and foot. You there, did you build this main wall in your father's time? Did you build this wall? Yes, my lord, I did. He replied that yes. What kind of a wall is that you built? It has fallen on a poor man and killed him. You have murdered him. We have to punish you by that. Now he said that you have to punish for that because that person was died. So you are the murderer. You have murdered him. Before the king could order the execution, the poor bricklayer pleaded. Pleaded means request. Bricklayer, one who lays bricks. Please listen to me before you give your order. It's true. I built this wall. It was no good, but this was because my mind was not on it. I remember very well a dancing girl. Now he pointed out a dancing girl who was going up and down that street all day with her anklets. Anklets? Anklets, jo pairon mein pehni jati hain, pajeb. Jingling. Jingling sound of anklet. But I could not keep my eye or my mind on the wall I was building. You must get that dancing girl. I know where she is. Now he said, this is not my fault. There was a girl who going up and down into the street and there was her anklets jingling. So he was unable to concentrate on the building of the wall. So this is his fault. This is her fault. I know where she lives. I also know where she lives. You are right. The case depends. We must look into it. It is not easy to judge such complicated cases. Let us get that dancer wherever she is. Now the king said, okay, then we will find out the dancer and the punishment should be given to her. So students, you are able to understand the story in the kingdom of fool. What happened? In the kingdom of fool, what happened? So students, you are able to understand. Thank you, students.